In this video, we're asked how many grams of CO2 are dissolved in 250 milliliters of bottled water under 1900 millimeters of mercury at 25 degrees Celsius. So here, if we want to carbonate this water, we have a direct application of Henry's law, which says that the solubility of our gas is going to equal K, which is the Henry's law constant, times the pressure of the gas. So our Henry's law constant is given as 3.1 times 10 to the minus 2 moles per liter atmosphere times the pressure of the gas, which is 1900 millimeters of mercury. And in this case, our constant's given in moles per liter atmosphere, and we have millimeters of mercury, so we need to convert this from millimeters of mercury to atmospheres. And one atmosphere is 760 millimeters of mercury. So our atmosphere are going to cancel out, and our solubility is going to be 3.1 times 10 to the minus 2 times 1900, which is 7.75 times 10 to the minus 2 moles per liter. Okay? Here we're asked, and this should be moles of CO2 per liter, but here we're asked how many grams dissolve in 250 milliliters. So we've seen molarity units before back in chapter four, so we have to use the same conversions that we did. So 250 milliliters will be 0.250 liters, so our liters cancel out. That leaves us with moles of CO2, and we know that for every one mole of CO2, we have 44.0 grams of CO2. So now our moles of CO2 cancel, and if we want to figure out how many grams, we take 7.75 times 44.01 times 0.250, and the grams of CO2 are 0.85 grams. Okay? And this is the amount that will dissolve under these particular conditions. So here we set up this problem. The equation is pretty straightforward, where the solubility is K times the pressure. We go through and we determine our concentration. Our concentration units are in molarity, which we've seen back in chapter 4. We have moles per liter. We multiply by our given volume. And then we multiply by the molecular weight of CO2. And that gives us 0.85 grams of CO2. And molarity is a concentration unit that we've seen before. And in the next video, we're going to talk about expressing concentrations in units other than molarity, and there are quite a few of them.